Hey guys, congrats on purchasing your brand new Crane M2. My name is Sydney DeYongsen and I'm gonna show you everything that you need to know to set up and operate your brand new gimbal so that you can get out there and film those smooth cinematic shots. Let's go. All right, let's start off with what's inside the case. Inside the case, you'll find the Crane M2 gimbal itself, as well as a mini tripod, camera screw, quick release plate, phone holder, wrist strap, and USB-C cable. Also, this case is actually pretty solid and strong enough to keep your gear safe. Before you set up the gimbal, you need to unlock the arms. To do that, simply switch the latch under the pan arm. To lock the axis arms, align the tilt and roll arms together and rest it on the gimbal. Then push both arms to lock it in place because there's a tiny pin that keeps those arms locked. And finally, switch the latch button to secure the gimbal. Easy. Now we're ready to balance the Crane M2. Take the gimbal out and attach the mini tripod like so. Take the quick release plate and attach it to the bottom of your camera using the thumb screw. For mirrorless cameras, use the long slot. And for smaller cameras, like phones and action cameras, use the short slot. If you're using a phone, make sure to use the included phone holder. Also, if you want to see a camera compatibility list, then visit the Zhiyun website. Once your camera is secured on the quick release plate, attach your camera to the gimbal and lock it in place by tightening the plate screw like so. To balance your gimbal, you just gotta observe how your camera leans and then move your camera setup in the opposite direction. I would suggest balancing the tilt and roll axis at the same time. Let's start with balancing the tilt, which is the arm that moves your camera up and down. If your setup leans forward, move it back. If your setup leans backwards, move it forward. To do that, simply loosen the screw under the plate and move your camera setup to a position you feel is mostly balanced. Next, point the camera up. If it leans forward, bring the tilt arm down. If it leans back, lift the tilt arm up. To do that, simply loosen the screw on the tilt axis. Then, just keep adjusting until the camera is balanced on its own. Next, let's balance the roll axis, which rolls your camera either to the left or the right. Just like before, observe where your camera leans and move it to the opposite direction. If your camera setup leans left, adjust the roll axis arm to the right. And if your setup leans to the right, adjust the roll axis arm to the left. To do that, simply loosen the screw on the roll axis and move your setup to where it is mostly balanced. Once balanced, tighten the screw on the roll axis. You may need to check the tilt and rebalance if necessary. Now, if you use the same camera setup with this gimbal, there is a useful little pin on the roll axis arm to save a balance point so that you don't have to rebalance this part of the gimbal every single time. And finally, let's balance the pan axis, which pans the camera to the left or the right. Lean the entire gimbal forward slightly towards the right. If the gimbal swings clockwise, you'll need to move the pan arm back. And if the gimbal swings counterclockwise, you'll need to move the pan arm forward. To do that, simply loosen the screw on the pan axis arm and move your camera setup to a position where it is mostly balanced. You may need to repeat this process until your camera setup remains in its position. Once all axes are balanced and locked, turn the Crane M2 on by sliding and holding the power button on the side. And that's it, you're done. Just kidding, you're not done. The Crane M2 should be ready to go straight out of the box, but let's go ahead and go over how the gimbal works so that you can operate it with ease. On the back of the Crane M2, you'll find a joystick to control the gimbal movements as well as navigate through the menu options. To access the menu, push the menu button on the side of the gimbal. Now you can see the menu options on the OLED display. In the menu, you can control the motor strength of the gimbal, connect to your camera via Wi-Fi, and even save different camera setups using history. On the side of the gimbal is a USB-C port to charge the M2, as well as update the firmware of the gimbal with the computer. And you can find out how to do that on the Zhiyun website. On the front of the gimbal is the trigger button, and on the back is the mode button, which both can enable different gimbal modes of the Crane M2. We'll get to that in a second. Next to the mode button is the photo video button, which of course records videos or takes photos when your camera is connected to the gimbal. Connecting your camera to the gimbal is actually pretty easy. Let me show you. Depending on what kind of camera you have, you can wirelessly connect your camera to the Crane M2 via Wi-Fi. For this demonstration, I'm using the Sony A6400, and all I'm going to do is open up the Wi-Fi connectivity so that it can be detected by the gimbal. Once Wi-Fi is enabled, open up the menu and select Wi-Fi by pressing right on the joystick. Give it a few seconds and the Crane M2 should automatically connect to your camera. Pretty cool. Now you can control the basic functions of the camera, like record, take a photo, and even zoom. So cool. Now let's talk about the different gimbal modes. The default mode of the Crane M2 is pan follow mode, which enables just the pan axis. In this mode, you're able to capture smooth shots without having to worry about any movements from the tilt axis. If you're in a different gimbal mode and you want to quickly go back to pan follow mode, just simply press the mode button in the back once. To enable follow mode, press the trigger button once. In this mode, all axes are enabled and you can move the gimbal in any direction. Press the trigger button twice to reset the gimbal back to its original position and press it 3 times to enable selfie mode so that you can film smooth looking vlogs. To enable lock mode, press the mode button once. In this mode, all axes are locked, and you can then film smooth cinematic shots down a straight line. This mode is also great for creative gimbal movements like rising low angle shots. To enable POV mode, press the mode button again from lock mode. In this mode, the gimbal can now roll your camera left or right. This makes for really cool and dynamic shots that are different than traditional gimbal movements. To enable go mode, press the mode button twice. In this mode, you can do quick pan movements to capture fast action scenes like sports or just running around with your kids. From go mode, press the mode button twice again to enable the last gimbal mode, vortex mode. In this mode, you can rotate your camera setup in an infinite loop to create mesmerizing shots, which makes for a really cool effect. The last thing that I'm going to show you is how to connect your gimbal to your phone using the ZY Play app. First, download the ZY Play app onto your device and turn on the Crane M2. Once downloaded, open up the app and your phone should be able to detect the gimbal automatically. Tap on your specific gimbal and you're connected. Next, you'll see two options, camera and smartphone. Let's start with camera mode. In camera mode, you'll be able to control the movements of your gimbal with the joystick and slider. And depending on what kind of camera you have, you can even control the basic functions of your camera like record video, take photos, and even zoom. To connect your camera wirelessly via the ZY Play app, make sure you enable the Wi-Fi connectivity on your camera so that the Crane M2 can detect it. On the app, tap the Wi-Fi icon and select your device. Some cameras like the A6400 even have a QR code to make it easier to connect to. If that's the case, use the QR code scanner within the app to connect to your camera. Going back to the app, there's an icon you can tap to open up options for panoramic photography, time-lapse, and trajectory photography. With trajectory photography, you can position the gimbal in any direction and then add waypoints within the app to make a motion time-lapse. Lastly, the icons on top indicate if you're connected to the gimbal via Bluetooth, a camera via Wi-Fi, and additional settings to calibrate your gimbal. In smartphone mode, it's just as you'd expect where you can use your phone as a camera on the Crane M2. Here, you can select different options like record in 4K, HDR, take panoramics, and all the usual functions most smartphones have to capture video and photo. But the really cool thing about smartphone mode is that you can track objects and the Crane M2 will follow.
So cool.
And that's it. Well, I know that was a lot of information, but congrats, you did it, you made it through. And also congrats again for purchasing the Crane M2. It's a great little gimbal. And if you do have any further questions, then by all means, use the service card that came with the Crane M2 to help answer any questions that you may have. But you are now ready to film some smooth cinematic shots and tell some awesome stories with the Crane M2. All right, guys, I'm out of here and I'll see you in the next one.